Hey, we just caught the male on a swim jig a little bit farther up. One of them, good female here. Look at that chunk. That's a big female. Put her back. Springtime fishing, post-spawn, a lot of fish are up here spawning, muddy water. Everybody and their brother up here throwing spinnerbait, chatterbait, flipping around. Swim jig's the deal. If I flip this, if I throw the general or some stick bait, you know, that Senko style bait, it's gonna take me forever to cover it. A swim jig, it's just a finesse jig, a small weed guard with this swim bait. I'm using the Habit grass pig on the back. That gives a little action. The swimming action looks like a shad. I can swim it along like a spinnerbait, but then I can drop it in the holes just like a worm or a jig. I can trigger the fish that are up eating shad. I can also get the ones protecting beds and the ones that are just hanging around cover here in tight spots. A swim jig, you get that Habit grass pig on the back, that swimming action. It's muddy. You can see lots of grass in here. Man, that's the deal in the springtime. The swim jig. He got it. Picking the grass on the grass pig. Now in terms of gear, the Revo, you can go with the SX. You don't need a ton of feel for it. Need cranking power. You know, I like that. The 8s, the 7s all the time, but a 6 is going to give you a little more cranking power. You want to reel it slow, so like a 6-to-1 is about right. Then the Veritas, the 7.3 is kind of my favorite all around. I can just cast a little bit farther. A medium heavy with this quarter ounce swim jig is about right. I've got a heavy today since I'm around a little more cover. Then the 15 pound Berkeley Trilene 100% fluorocarbon. It's plenty to get them out in here. You can go to them if they get buried up. The fish don't see it as well, so if I get in a little bit of clear water, I don't feel like I'm spooking them like I do with the braid. And that Trilene, that fluorocarbon, plenty of horsepower to pull them out. Now real quick, how you work this thing, you can work it one of two ways. I like the rod tip up if I'm trying to come over the top of cover, a lot of grass like this. If it's matted hydrilla milfoil, have my rod tip up. I'll kind of twitch just a little bit. I'll make that jig come across the top of the grass and just jerk, jerk, jerk. That little stop and go makes them eat. If I'm trying to get it into the cover more, a lot of these spots you see, there's little holes, there's little gaps. That's where the fish are spawning. I'll put my rod tip down, just plow through the grass. And when I hit a hole, I'll stop it, I'll kill it. Let it fall right down in there. If there's a bed, the fish on a bed, it's going to eat it right there. Swim jig chunker. Hey, so we've caught him in the grass, caught him in the wood on the swim jig. You know, it's just like a jig. You can throw it in by a hardwood, let it sink, catch them on the fall, you can swim it, catch them like a spinnerbait. Like I said, swim jig with that Habit grass pig, grass or wood, catch the pigs.